Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, and as you can see I have a full face of makeup already done because I'm going to be doing an in-depth and honest review on Anisa sunscreens. I think previously in my sunscreen rundown I was talking about the other Perfect UV sunscreen, which I really do like, but since then I've discovered that they actually have another variation of that in the tube form, which is the whitening UV sunscreen gel, which I actually prefer, but I'll talk about that a little later. But today this sunscreen, as well as these two new launches from Anisa, are going to be the sunscreens that I'm going to be talking about and reviewing and demoing for you guys. So the final look that I have here is actually my favorite way to wear these products and the way that I believe that really flatters the skin best. But before we go into that, I just want to remind you guys that I have timestamps in the comments as well as the description box, so you can click the respective timestamps to see different sections of this video. But yeah, let's just start off with the first Anisa sunscreen, which is the one that I've gotten the most comments about actually, because it is a new launch and it almost seems too good to be true. A sunscreen compact. This is the Anisa sunscreen compact, and it's marketed to be a makeup base. So it comes in two shades, which obviously sucks, but I am in natural and it matches me and NC20 pretty well. I would say that the compact version, after it kind of oxidizes, it does turn a fraction bit darker, but nothing past like an NC25 from MAC Foundations. So that being said, I'm just going to show you how I apply this. Today, all the application was on a cleansed face, no toner, no moisturizer, but I will show you why also, because one of the sunscreens actually have a beautiful texture, which I've layered on today, and it gives me sufficient hydration for my oily dehydrated skin. But going back to the makeup base, I would say that this is really not gonna be what you think it's gonna be. I think because it comes in like a cushion compact, a lot of people think that it's gonna be a cushion, but actually it's just a solid kind of sunscreen, a solid tinted sunscreen. So if you've seen like balms or tinted balms or cream foundations, this is going to be comparable to a lot of those kind of products. And I say that in the best way possible, because I myself am a person that doesn't really like cushions anymore. I feel like if I ever wanted to do a cushion foundation or get a cushion foundation, I'd much rather make my own because it's more handy that way. So when I saw that this wasn't a cushion foundation, I was really intrigued. So firstly, when I was applying it onto my skin, I'm just going to strictly talk about application and also how it looks on the skin, the coverage, the finish, how long it lasts. So when I was applying it onto the skin on a bare face, the first thing I noticed was that it looks pretty heavy right off the bat. I'm just going to say that you can very easily pick up a lot of the product, just like any real cream foundation. But for this, it even is a lot more kind of emollient a texture, so it's not like a stiff cream, it's actually pretty emollient and quite slippy, so it's very easy to pick up too much. What I've learned is that if you overdo it on the skin, even though it has this appearance of looking pretty velvet, I would say it actually feels quite creamy on the skin. Like physically touching the skin, it does feel a little bit creamy. So that being the case, start very slow and then build it up. But that being said, because the finish is kind of fickle, and the best way I would like to apply this is basically very little and just spreading it as much as I can all over the face. That being said, it might not give you sufficient sun protection, so I would highly suggest using this on top of your regular sunscreen, even though this does have SPF in it. But I would say that as a makeup product, it isn't the most aesthetic in terms of the way it's being used. Not so much visually. Visually, it looks great for some reason, and even when I overdo it, it really looks like it's matte on my skin, like a very soft matte. It does accentuate my pores. I do feel a layer of makeup sitting on my skin. It doesn't behave like a very fluid texture, so that's something that I don't really enjoy. From other kind of cream products that I've used in the past, which aren't sunscreen based, but this in particular, I believe is strictly attributed to the fact that it's kind of wet. It's a wet, balmy texture. That's why it sits a little bit weird on the skin as compared to other cream or liquid type foundations, which either choose to be a liquid or choose to be a balm that is a little bit more drying, so that when you apply it on top of a moisturized base, it looks good. But this already has a little bit of emollients to it.
Okay, so I wasn't really sure how to show you, because when I look back at the footage, it doesn't really show what I'm trying to explain in terms of the heaviness on the skin. So this is the best way I know how. I'm gonna come up pretty close. I feel the product on my skin and it looks like I have stuff on my skin, even though it does look like a very beautiful finish. And fortunately or unfortunately, this is like my ideal application already, but it still looks pretty heavy. I feel like my... okay, those foundations I really like, not those that I don't like. I really like the Makeup Forever Reboot Foundation, the Bourjois Healthy Mix Serum and everything like that. They look well blended into my skin, whereas this, with finger application like how I would normally, sits on the skin pretty heavy and I feel it on my skin. I literally feel like I need to rub it off because it feels so heavy. But yeah, I guess it looks good, which is the tricky part, but it's honestly sitting on my skin like a layer, so that's not entirely great. But I think I hope this illustrates it, because if you can see it on camera, you can be damn sure you can see it in real life. And this is the shade Natural. Yeah, and it matches me, I guess, perfectly. But honestly, my skin tone is pretty pale as compared to, like, let's say my hand in comparison. So my face is usually a little fairer. But yeah, I'm an NC20 and that's pretty much the people that it will match. So yeah.
Alright, the next one is the BB foundation. I would say that in terms of usage, this is a lot easier because you can just squeeze it like a regular kind of sunscreen and apply it all over your face. With your fingers is the best application method, but you can also use a brush. I suggest not to use a sponge because it will eat up a lot of the product. But with this, I would say that coverage-wise, the compact has more coverage, but the liquid, it's easier to use because similar to the compact, I would use very little of this also. I really only want to use it to kind of tint my skin and not so much anything to do with coverage. This has a light coverage. It doesn't build up to anything too full coverage, so that's a bit of a downside. But you can probably see the left and right, the before and after on my skin. You can still see my freckles and everything like that, and I did apply quite a lot of this. And yeah, I would say that if you apply it with a brush, it will leave streak marks because, like I said, it doesn't set down to anything. For the BB foundation, it actually looks a little bit more juicy on the skin. It's not too flat a matte. But yeah, that's just really attributed to the fact that, you know, with the compact, you use a sponge, so it does eat up a lot of the moisture from the balm. But other than that, using your fingers for this is great. And like I mentioned, I'm going to do that swipe test where I just use my finger to swipe. This one has a lot more transfer than the compact foundation, but I would say that in terms of the fact that, you know, this strictly I would just use as a quick tint on the skin, I would say that I would prefer buying this because you just need a few drops and just, like, you know, you don't even really need a mirror and just, like, massage it all over the face, and that would be a quick one and done. Yeah, like I mentioned, it also only comes in two shades, which isn't great. But in terms of the Anissa sunscreen that I really, really like, this is the Whitening UV Sunscreen Gel. And I previously preferred the, you know, this is the perfect UV range. And there's also, like, a golden tube, which you can see in my sunscreen rundown. I used to like that because I did not try this, but that had a very, like, opaque and velvety finish on the skin with no coverage. It's just a translucent cream. But for this, it comes out like a white substance, but on the skin it leaves a very dewy, not super dewy, just a slight glossing on the skin, which makes it look really, really healthy. The whitening kind of claim is bullshit. It's actually just a glossy finish on the skin. There's no white cast, no visible white cast in my opinion. And this has a lighter texture than that of the Perfect UV Gel, which I previously reviewed. But yeah, I really like this. So my recommended usage for all of these products is basically to go in with your regular sunscreen. And for me, I would like to use this. So when I use this, I kind of apply quite a lot on my face to give it sufficient hydration as well. And after I do that, I will either use, you know, this or this. So today, for my skin complexion, for what I have achieved with my face, I actually used this makeup base and I applied very, very little, only on the perimeters of my face, so that it gave me a little bit of tint, a little bit of color like a bronzer would. And then I went in with a little bit of concealer, and today with the eyes and lips, I decided to do a monochromatic look. But that's my recommended usage with all these products. Really, it's not about having these two to replace your makeup base. I would just suggest, like, even if you're not gonna pick these two up, just go in with your sunscreen, apply your concealer, do your makeup. You know, what's the difference to me? I feel like these two, if they're gonna be replacements for foundations, it really has to perform like foundations, but it doesn't have that much coverage. It's really just a tint, and the finish is each to its own. For me, I don't really like velvety finishes. And I feel like it's a bit too high a claim to have sunscreen products perform like makeup products. But I would say that these are beautiful if you just want like a tinted moisturizer replacement, but instead a tinted sunscreen. But you would still have to do your regular makeup routine as per what it is, because it really doesn't feel that equivalent to a foundation. So this BB drops and this kind of compact, I would say really just experiment with the use of it. And like I mentioned, I'll leave in the description box as well my recommended use. But other than that, if you do choose to pick it up yourself, really experiment with it and see whether or not you like to mix it in your foundation. But definitely don't use these as your sole sun protection, because if it looks weird on the skin, like it looks too heavy on the skin, you would tend to apply less, and that will compromise your sun protection. So yeah, ingredient list, everything will be in the description box. I will also probably do Insta stories on my IG, so feel free to check me out there and DM me if you have any questions. So without further rambling, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!